In this video, we will look at an example script to understand the API lookup_transform. This is one of the most important and useful TF APIs. The next API transform we will learn in the next video. All right, the example script is available in the hrwros_week5 ROS package that comes with the downloads for this week. So, we navigate to the scripts folder in the package with ROSCD. And let's inspect the Python scripts in this folder in the Atom editor. Recall that in the very first video of this module, we saw the output of the robot squabblers ROS node, where the two robot arms were having a dispute about the location of the turtlebot. Well, that node actually uses the lookup_transform API to create the dispute as well by looking up the position of the turtlebot relative to the two robot arms. So, let's open that Python script and find out how this is done. So, we have the necessary Python imports as always. We have the ROSPY import as usual. And here, we import the tf2_ros module that gives us access to all the tf2_ros APIs. Then, here are two lists of strings which we will come back to in a short while from now. Let's now dive into the robot_squabblers function. First things first, we will initialize a ROS node called robot_squabblers. Then we will create the TF buffer that we learned about in the last video, and this buffer will store transform information for the past 10 seconds as we are not explicitly specifying any duration in the declaration. Then we associate the buffer to a TF listener so that transform information on the TF topic is constantly updated to the TF buffer as and when new TF messages become available. Then we have some helper variables to update information regarding the transforms and also display relevant log messages. And here we see the API lookup_transform being used to query relative information between the base link of robot1 and the base link of the turtlebot, which is just called base_link. And the last argument, rospy.time, is a way to indicate we would like to get the latest available transform information between these two reference frames from the TF buffer. The API itself returns both translation and rotation information between the two reference frames. But here, we will only use the translation information. Then, we compose a message that displays this transform information using the list of strings we defined above for each robot and a helper variable to pick which string to display. And finally, the transform information is printed via the print function. A similar approach is followed for the relative position information between the base link of robot 2 and the base link of the turtlebot as well. The rate_pub helper variable is just to add a delay between the printing of the different strings. And the rate_listener helper variable is to specify a duration to wait for before querying for a transform information in the buffer in case the required transform messages were not yet available in the buffer at the first time of querying. Note that although we use a buffer to store transform messages, it is still good practice to put the lookup_transform query within a try and catch block. This prevents us from running into warnings and errors when we query for a transform from the TF buffer before the relevant transform messages are updated into the buffer. Lastly, an important point to remember is that the lookup_transform API returns a transform message which consists of translation and rotation information. While this is very similar to a POS or a post-stamped information, a transform is not the same as a post-stamped or a POS message. We can definitely create a post-stamped information using the transform information by specifying the relevant reference frame. After this video, use the ROS-MSG command to see for yourself the difference between a transform message type and a post-stamped message type. All right then, that was about the lookup underscore transform API. In the next video, we will learn how to use the transform API.